a 10-story treehouse, and guitar pee. Vsauce, Kevin here. This is mind blowing. The Denver Zoo has its very own poop-powered rickshaw. Called the Tour de Tuk Tuk, it uses animal poop and trash as fuel. They're hoping to implement this gasification system to eventually convert 90% of the zoo's waste into usable energy, which would eliminate 1.5 million pounds of trash every year. To get your car off the ground, there's the PAL V1. This personal air and land vehicle is a driving autogyro. The rotor on top doesn't provide lift like a helicopter. Instead, the power is actually provided by a rotor at the rear. And if power goes out, it can be safely maneuvered to land like a glider. $8,000 dog stair lift. Noisy Jelly is a game where you play with musical jello. The game board is a capacitive sensor, and the different shapes and salt concentrations of the jello molds affect the audio signal. If you're more interested in having a pizza button, there's the VIP fridge magnet. Red Tomato Pizza is sending these magnets to their most loyal customers, whose favorite order is preset based on their order history. It works in conjunction with any Bluetooth-enabled phone, and is like having your very own pizza bat signal. To shake hands from afar, you'll need this telepresence robot hand device. It communicates grip force and body temperature in an attempt to accurately transmit a person's handshake, with the hand made of silicone rubber and sponge. Which seems kind of awkward, but a transparent swiveling screen could make video conferencing less awkward. The goal is to improve the experience by giving the speaker a better virtual representation, so it looks a little less like you're just talking to a screen. This graphene-based device can spot bacteria on your teeth and transmit it wirelessly. Bringing objects to fruition with robot pebbles is the goal of Smart Sand Technology from MIT. It's a bit complicated, but basically you could insert an object into the smart sand, and the individual grains would analyze and selectively attach to each other, forming a new 3D object. It could be used to assemble large-scale replicas of smaller models of objects that you put into the sand. Finally, although unfortunately not a real game, here's what a first-person Bomberman would look like. I'm gonna leave you with an app to talk to apes. And as always, thanks for watching.